Today I am going to read the story The Moon Wheat written by Rashi Jaiswal. It was the midst of April. Early dawn embraced and even sent stars similar to the hope in an oblivion. I was lying on the ground with the eyes gazing at the sky marooned with stars. The sound of the river flowing by romanticized the twilight. I fancied talking to the moon, which grew bigger that night. The soft breeze stroked my hair and my eyes followed the rhythm. I closed my eyes and tried to feel every inch of the space I shared that night. I heard the insects singing lullabies, the aroma of the flowers, the green grass, the soil, which was not completely wetted, a flavor to hear and I inhaled. I rotated my eyes to the extremity, but there was no motion except the trees fighting with the wind which blew. Once again, I was lost in the twilight game. My eyes gradually narrowed the snooze. The soft breeze stroked my head again. I sensed something unusual at the very moment. My eyelids clasped tightly with one another refused to open. My body seemed paralyzed, unresponsive, but could sense, feel and speak. I sensed a hand on my palms, whose warmth was as comforting as anything. The scent which the touch carried was totally unique. I tried to move, open my eyes, remove my hand, but I was helpless. I shouted, "Who are you?" A voice very familiar, which I had been listening and dreaming of for many nights, spoke. "I am whom you dream of every night. I am whom you long to listen to forever. I am whom you wanted to spend your entire life with, looking at the stars. I am whom you wanted to travel galaxies with. I am you planned your trip to the moon with. I am who promised to never leave your hand. I am the one who promised to never leave you alone. I am the hush." I interrupted him, "but I have never seen you before. I have never met you before. I have never ever talked to you before. I don't think I know you. You remember the night you were talking endlessly to the moon?" And I replied back, "It was me who did that. I don't know how, but I fell for you. When I am with you, I understand the inspiration behind those beautiful novels. I understand Juliet's sacrifice, Elizabeth's strength, and Jane's dedication. You don't know, but you are special. You are the one." I was dying to open my eyes and look into his eyes. I wanted to shout, scream, love him, run. I wanted to hold his hand and ask him to stand by my side the way he did every time. I felt his hand again on mine. This time it was as cold as the iceberg Titanic crashed into, as if the intensity of the words which he had now spoken made it warm. "Take care," he said, and planted a soft kiss on my forehead, his voice now stammering. The intensity of his voice lowered, and his presence faded in the darkness. I opened my eyes and saw the moon. Up there in the boundaries of midnight, I looked for the voice I just spoke to. I shouted. I hunted for him, my eyes dying just to take a glimpse of him. I wanted to hold his hand and tell him everything I had. I wanted to spend hours talking to him under the first sky. There was no sign of a mortal in extremities. He vanished. He just vanished. I sat up and looked up at the moon again, with so many questions in my eyes lurking to be answered. This time it winked at me from behind the clouds and faded away. If you like my stories, then subscribe my channel. Please.